Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. 1 Samuel 2 1-7. Then Hannah prayed and said, "My heart rejoices in the Lord my horn is lifted high. My mouth boasts over my enemies, for I delight in your deliverance. There is no one holy like the Lord, there is no one besides you, there is no rock like our God. Do not keep talking so proudly or let your mouth speak such arrogance, for the Lord is a God who knows, and by him deeds are weighed. The bows of the warriors are broken, but those who stumbled are armed with strength. Those who were full hire themselves out for food, but those who were hungry are hungry no more. She who was barren has borne 7 children, but she who has had many sons pines away. The Lord brings death and makes alive, he brings down to the grave and raises up. The Lord sends poverty and wealth, he humbles and he exalts." Today's title is "There's No One Besides You." There are some who believe that Christians are sexist. They somehow think that Christians consider women inferior to men. I don't know where they got such an idea. If we Christians somehow gave such an impression, it is totally our fault. The Bible never gave such an idea. The Bible certainly believes that there is a different roles for men and women. That's obvious. If there is no difference in the role of women and men, why would God create us as male and female? So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God he created them, male and female he created them. Genesis 1:27. The Lord affirmed this too. "Haven't you read," he replied, "that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female?" Matthew 19:4. So the Bible strongly opposes the view of some who seem to argue that there is no difference between man and woman at all. At the same time, the Bible rejects any idea of male dominance or female inferiority. I believe the song of Hannah is clear proof of it. Although Hannah was a humble and miserable woman, she shows the most profound understanding of sovereign God through the song. Of course, we have seen God's sovereignty throughout different stages of redemptive history. But no one seems to have put it so beautifully as Hannah. That's why this song becomes a model for many other spiritual songs in the coming ages, including Mary's so-called Magnifica. I personally believe that many of David's psalms share the same theme as Hannah's song. The fact that Hannah found the profound knowledge of God through her agony and trouble and pass it down to the generations of believers to me is clear proof of God's impartiality between man and woman. See how clearly she knew who God is. "There is no one holy like the Lord, there is no one besides you, there is no rock like our God. Do not keep talking so proudly or let your mouth speak such arrogance, for the Lord is a God who knows, and by him, deeds are weighed." Hannah knows that our God is the one and only trustworthy God. He is God who searches into our hearts. She knows that our God is sovereign and full of power and authority. Death and life, poverty and wealth all derive from him. The Lord brings death and makes alive, he brings down to the grave and raises up. The Lord sends poverty and wealth, he humbles and he exalts. At the same time, he is God full of love and compassion. So her heart rejoices in the Lord. "My heart rejoices in the Lord, my horn is lifted high. My mouth boasts over my enemies, for I delight in your deliverance." Did you find this Hannah's God as she did? Do you love him as Hannah did? Then, your heart must rejoice in the Lord too.